Can you relate to that?
No, but not yet. No.
Okay, so we're introducing Kyle to NF. He's never heard of him, never seen anything. And we've never heard the song either, so... Yeah, we're introducing him on a song we've never heard, so we'll see how it goes. Do you want to introduce yourself?
Hey, I'm Kyle. What was I about to say? Oh, yeah, follow me on Insta. Follow me on Twitter. Fire_KY. Follow me on Twitter. K_B2019. Yeah, that's it. K_B2019. But really, just look up Kyle.
Let's get into it.
Like the intro?
Yeah. Most of my life's full of sad days. Started at a young age, yeah. Bought a house, but I've been living on stage. Trying to find a real me, I ain't found it yet. Wake up every morning feeling like I'm guilty. Talk to God, can you hear me? Lately I'm a mess, I don't want no one to help me. Yeah, I don't want no one to help me. And if you...
Okay, okay. I'm gonna pause him when he finishes this. And he just keeps going, keeps going.
For real. So far so good on the message though. Like, grass is always greener kind of situation.
Most of my life is full of sad days. Started at a young age.
Yeah, bought a house, but I've been living on stage. But I'm sure the famous can, like, the rich and, like, the life of the rich and famous, like, you know, we see what we see on the media. We don't see what they really are like, what their life's really like.
So most of your life is full of happy days.
I mean, yeah, I'd say, yeah.
Good, shoot, good. I don't know, for me, I said mostly has been happy, but on the times where it's been sad, it's been like every day for a very long time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Yeah. And then it'd be like rarely there's a happy day during that period. Like, it's mostly sad days.
No, I'm saying like when depression hits.
It's it's like all the time you're sad and then rarely you have a happy day. Oh, I'm good. Depression's over. Newsflash. You know what I mean?
Right. Life goes on.
Right.
I feel you. It's like, you know, I get upset about something and it's like, be upset for a minute, but then, like, you get over.
I don't want no one to help me, yeah. I don't want no one to help me, and if you think that I make decisions based off of what you think, then you're wrong. Can't nobody think for me, I got my own thoughts. Sometimes you don't know what you had until it's all gone, till it's all gone. If I took the hand that was dealt me, then I would be nowhere.
You like that part?
Yeah. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, like, he's easier to follow than the other dude. Like, the other dude was just, like...
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
He spoke very fast. It's like, you know, him I can keep up with.
Yeah. He's talking about Hobson. We just introduced him to Hobson on a different video. But if you think I make decisions based off what you think, then you're wrong. I feel like people love to give that unsolicited advice.
Right.
It's like,
right.
Do you really think this person cares about what you're saying? Right. Like, no one asked you for your advice. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, something that...
It's crazy.
Something that I feel like in recent years, I just come to, like, start to understand is that, like, everybody thinks they're the smartest, most beautiful, most epic, incredible creature on this earth. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, low-key, everybody's so egotistical.
Yeah, we all are. I mean...
Yeah, you need a little pride to get through life, but, you know, it's way...
And I feel like there is a degree, like, some people will have, like, realism, you know what I mean? Some people will have, like, they'll balance themselves, but it's, like, fundamentally, everybody thinks they're the best at everything. Like,
but
you know what I mean?
And
I'm not the best at that because I haven't practiced it, but I should.
But I'm the best at knowing what I'm not the best at.
Exactly.
And once you have that realism, that's when you really start to grow up. It's like, once you start to have that realism, and, you know, that's when you start to see life for what it is. It's like, oh, okay, adjust.
Okay, so how old are you?
24.
So when did that start to set in for you, that realism?
After college. I'm not going to lie. College was still very much... Because college was basically the same as high school. Get good grades and keep achieving in life. You know, get good grades, join this club, join that club. It's like, same thing, just, you know, now I'm keeping my own schedule in a sense.
It's like, after college, the real world hits you.
Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely after college.
Yeah.
It hits you and, you know, it's pretty much sink or swim.
Yeah, I remember when you first graduated, you got smacked pretty good by the real world.
Yeah.
Can't nobody think for me, I got my own thoughts. Sometimes you don't know what you had until it's all gone. till it's all gone. If I took the hand that was dealt me, then I would be nowhere in life. Yeah, I had to think smart. Threw away the deck and got my own cards. Long before I had the money to afford a car. I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Following my dreams. Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Following my dreams. Yeah, I've been doing me.
Oh, yeah, that part is talking about Peter's, played the hand he was life dealt him or whatever, he'd be nowhere. Mm-hmm. I feel that's so true for like 99% of people. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's like even all the successful people, we like to just look at them like, oh, they're successful now. But like the hand they were dealt was probably just as bad as like one of the hands we were dealt. Right. You know what I mean? Like
y'all remember that TV show Glee?
Yeah.
They used to have, it was this pop song they did called like Loser Like Me. And it's like, it was just so true, exactly what y'all was saying, of like, you know, almost everybody in life, you know, they probably were like a loser at some point. You know, they were probably like anyone who's ever been famous or did something great. Yeah. They probably were also the kid getting stuffed in the lockers. It's in a sense.
Right. At least they had hard times.
Yeah. You know? Even if you're born with a silver spoon, what if like the nature is to do something different?
Right.
I feel like it's also a sense of realism. Like when you start to realize like, when you start to realize that everybody is always, you know, worried about what someone else thinks, that's really, like, those are, like, you know, just, like you said, like, you start doing you, you know, stop focusing on, like, what everybody else thinks and just do you. Like, what do I think? What am I trying to achieve? Mm-hmm. Like, the ultimate goal is to be better than you were yesterday, in a sense.
Right.
And, like, that's what he's doing. Like, I'm working hard. I'm being better than I was yesterday.
Right. He's not just accepting, like, the hand he was dealt.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I've been doing me, following my dreams, yeah, I've been doing me. Most of my life's full of regrets, things I wanna take back, yeah. Wrote you a letter, wish that I had never sent that. Didn't even make sense, I don't even know. All I know is I get lower on the weekends. They tell me I should make friends, I just sit at home. Lately I've been off the deep end, yeah. I've been on the deep end, and if you think that I'm about to change who I am just for you, then you're so wrong. As a kid, I built a house around my broke car. Sometimes you don't know what you had until it falls apart. Till it falls apart. If I took that.
Right, I like this flow in this song.
Mm. For real.
Like, what do you call this? Right?
I don't even know.
Like you're almost getting lost in it. I'm trying to think, like, wait, what were the lyrics just again? I just heard something else.
It's like, it puts you in a trance. Just gets you deep thinking. Right? Like,
I like the way he's like switching up the flow and stuff when he gets to like the part where we're at right now. How he's like, kind of singing in it. You know what I mean? Like. This is tough.
That's true. What was I about to say?
You on that part where he said his life is full of mostly regrets, you were like,
Oh, yes.
You have a lot of regrets?
Not a lot, but I definitely have some regrets. I wouldn't say a lot, because sometimes you think regrets, it's like, well, you know, the stuff you did as a kid, that's like, okay, I got punished for it, but it's like, it's not really a big deal in the grand scheme of things. But then you think about, like, you know, the older you get, that's what I heard. Like, the older you get, the more expensive your mistakes cost. End up being
true. That's true. I almost want to sing it. And I'm not going to hurt everyone's ears like that. If you think that I'm about to change who I am just for you, then you're so wrong. I don't know. Okay, that part. I like that part. You know what I mean? Because people really do kind of expect you to, like, change your whole person for them.
I think it's always the, like, worst when people get in a relationship and... I mean, I'm even guilty of this, but you get in a relationship and then you think, like, oh, you're going to, like, improve upon this person. Like, you know what I mean? You think you're going to get them to be, like, your perfect version of them. And you're so wrong.
Right.
Lesson of life. Your soulmate is supposed to be your compliment, not your missing piece.
Mm.
It's like, if this is the person you're supposed to be with, they're supposed to compliment you. You're supposed to, you know, each enjoy doing your own things together and apart. But they're supposed to compliment you to rise you up. Not be like... you're missing peace. Like, you need this person, in a sense.
I mean, I agree with that. I definitely agree with that. I don't know how you know that. 24. No soulmate.
I watch a lot of TV.
Sometimes you don't know what you had until it falls apart. Till it falls apart. If I took the hand that was dealt me, then I would be nowhere in life. Yeah, I had to think smart. Threw away the deck and got my own cards. Long before I had the money to afford a car. I've been doing me, I've been doing me, yeah, I've been doing me. I've been
doing me. Following my dreams, yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. I've been doing me, yeah, I've been doing me. Following my dreams, yeah, I'm just doing me, yeah, I'm just doing me. I'm reminiscing back to both of us laughing, playing old records, thinking every one of them's classic. Windows down, we on the street, up in Michigan rapping. We talked about it, but never really knew it could happen. My confidence about as low as the gases. We didn't have the money for it, so we turned to keep backwards and sit in parking lots for hours till the battery crashes. I think that we related, cause both of us were looking for answers a couple months.
What were you saying?
I'm getting so much Hamilton vibes from this.
See, I don't know Hamilton.
Oh, one of these days I'm about to introduce y'all to it.
Sounds long.
I mean, granted it's a Broadway play, but it was like one of the most biggest cultural icons within the past 10 years.
My confidence is about as low as the gas is.
Gas kind of high.
True. Yeah, but he's talking about his gas needle. You know?
Oh, the needle.
Yeah, Lex.
See, I was thinking gas prices.
You didn't get that?
I was like, dang, you know, it could be
lower. See, y'all grew up different. Yeah, I didn't grow up putting $5 in the gas tank. You know what I mean? Just going from E to quarter tank.
I mean, my dad, I mean.
I got it, but.
Yeah,
okay, you got it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I just missed it.
He said we didn't have money for it, so we turned to keep backwards and sit in parking lots for hours till the battery crashed. Wait, who is he talking about? Is he talking about his notepad again?
Right?
Or who's the robbery? We?
Maybe his
mom. Who's the we?
Could be his siblings. Could be his notepad. Like, it depends. Could be his own, could be his parents, could be cousins, like anyone, could be his friends.
We didn't have the money for it, so we turned to keep backwards and sit in parking lots for hours till the battery crashes. I think that we related, cause both of us were looking for answers a couple months ago. I drove in the Glad and got me all of my feelings. There's something about being somewhere that's familiar. Pulling the gas station, open up the tank, then I fill it, then laugh. Would I move back? Not in a million, but I appreciate the memories we had. I know you've been calling, sorry, I never called back. I know I've been distant, you know I never meant that. You can tell the family how I'm doing if they ask. I'm just doing me.
Okay, so he's talking about someone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that whole would he move back? Not in a million years.
It could be like a speech to
appreciates all the good times he's had.
It could be like a speech to someone, or like maybe he's like it could be like a speech to someone or about someone. But it's like, you know, they're wondering, like, this person could be wondering, it's like, if you wonder what's going on, I've been doing me.
What's that's your first take, first impression of NF? What do you think?
I like him. Like you said, just doing your own thing. Don't worry about what other people think. Just do you and you'll succeed.
Yeah, so he has a lot of different styles and stuff. Now, this is our first time hearing him, like, kind of in this style. Yeah. What did you say?
Yeah.
I mean, he's similar.
Similar, but nothing just like this.
Yeah, like sometimes sometimes he'll rap like hardcore. Mm-hmm. Like, his songs always have a good message, but sometimes he'll be like spazzing on a track. You know what I mean? Other times he'll be more like singing and stuff. Like he's very versatile. Spazzing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah. I feel you. Well, I mean, I do like this. Like, if he wants, like, I think he can definitely make a definite market out of, like, well, there's a market for, like, you know, hip, like, there's a market for this kind of, for slow hip-hop in a sense. Like,
how many subscribers do you think he has?
If I had to guess, I'd say at least, you say he was a YouTube rapper or was he mainstream?
No, he doesn't get much radio play, but he has won a Grammy before.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, so he's big. Okay, he's at least big. I'd say at least in the millions, like at least like 1.2 mil or something. It's like, I don't think there's a huge market, but
there you go.
Okay, yes. Okay, definitely more, but yeah, in the millions, 6.96 mil. It's like not the biggest, not a huge market, but a definite market for his music. What?
Nothing.
You gotta see, we gotta show you something.
That's huge. 7 million? Yeah. You don't think that's huge? You think that's a small
Grammy,
market?
7 million.
He beat out Chance the Rapper for a Grammy. He doesn't get a lot of radio play because he's not rapping about drugs and guns and stuff. You know what I mean?
I'm just thinking more than millions.
But he has, 7 million subs.
Yeah. We got to show you some of his music videos, too.
Oh, you'll love his music videos.
They're crazy.
They're very theatrical.
Okay. I mean, I love a good theater. Like, I love a good performance.
Thank you, Kyle, for joining us on the couch, Couch Gang. Comment below your thoughts on this video. Like the video. Subscribe to our channel for more.
Follow me on Insta and Twitter. Twitter, fire_KY, and Insta, K_B2019.
Until next time, that's a wrap.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. I see the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't.